Hey everybody, welcome back. This is Jack Canfield, Jack and Jill, you love that, author of Chicken Soup for the Soul and Success Principles. And Jack is a walking demonstration of publicity in action. I wanted him to share some helpful tips for you today for how to get outstanding publicity.
Well, one thing I recommend to everybody, and really it wasn't my idea, it was one of my students, Mykola Latansky from the Ukraine. He does a 3-minute live video every day, and then it goes out live, but then he also posts it everywhere. But I'm talking 7 days a week. I was doing a seminar for authors at my house. I walk into my office. He's in there with his camera going, look at Jack Canfield's library. There are 3,000 books here. Leaders are readers. So he's always giving somebody some value. And then what he does, at the end he says, and by the way, I'll be in Kiev on such and such a date, and let all your friends know. When he started doing this, he was getting like 60 people in his workshops. Now he gets 600 to 1,000 people at his workshops, and it goes viral. And he pushes the books out and does all the, you know, the what is it, jab, jab, right hook, Gary Vaynerchuk stuff as well. So that's one thing I really strongly recommend, and I'm doing that now as well. We record all of ours on one day, and then we drip them out over the course of a month. The other thing is, you never want to go anywhere where you don't have your book. So many authors that come, they don't have their book with them. Now, sometimes it might not be possible, but I always carry these postcards. These are two different books of mine. And on the back, it tells you about it. There's some endorsements about it. And then it says, order your copy at www.amazon.com or go to jackcanfield.com. So these are things you can always hand out, because you'll tell people about your book and they forget about it. They just don't remember. But if they have to go home and, oh yeah, I've got this thing here, and therefore I can then do that. The third thing is...
And they want to buy your book, please. So have it so you can offer it to them.
Right, right. If I always carry two or three in my travel case, and I'll sell them right there on the spot.
That's right.
Or often I'll give them, if they're influencers, I'll give it to them. And the other thing is that, and I would say this, always say yes, especially when you're starting out. Say yes. I mean, I would do radio interviews at 1 a.m, but I thought maybe some truck driver driving through Idaho would hear it, and he would buy it and then tell his daughter about it, and she would tell 3 friends and so forth and so on. So when you're first starting, you know, cable television, local access, you know, podcasts, anyone where you can get anywhere. And now there's directories of podcasts you can buy, and you can go online. I just went online, there's over 200 podcasts just on success. So with my success book, I've been on a lot of those, and we're still searching out for the rest of them. But the main thing is to be thinking as a marketer. When Chicken Soup for the Soul came out, we did 5 things a day. We bought the book, 1,001 Ways to Market Your Book by John Kramer. And we took 750 post-its of the things that would work, put them on a wall. It took us a year and a half. Every day we'd take a post-it off and do that thing. Chicken Soup did not hit the bestseller list until 14 months after it came out. Most people give up after 6 months if they're not on the bestseller list. So it's a long-term commitment that you make. And I'll just share one last thing I learned from Scott Peck, who wrote The Road Less Traveled. And that book was on the bestseller list for over 12 years. That's 600 weeks. And I think that was the longest ever. And he said to me, when I asked him about how to do that, he said, the first year, do 3 radio interviews every day. And then for the next 5 years, do 1 a day. And he said, that's how he kept it on the list. Every day I was doing at least 1 radio interview. And today might be a podcast, whatever it is. But it's that consistent effort over time that's going to get you where you want to go.
Thank you. And here's what you're hearing. The consistency, the persistency of a man who's successful. And the point is, success continues. These are some great tips. Thank you so much, Jack.
You're welcome, Jill. Anytime.